Just outside of Pornic lie several acres of polythene tunnels. They may not be pretty to look at, but what they contain would keep Wimbledon going for years. The Mayard family have been growing strawberries on this site since 1992.
Today we've got 5 hectares in greenhouse like that, and we produce 80 tons from end of April till end of October.
The mild coastal climate, which I so loved in my student summer here, together with the sheltering greenhouses, allows the strawberries to mature very quickly. I'm glad to see that the farm uses very few chemicals. Their methods are traditional and very organic. Rainwater is collected for irrigation, and bees are kept to promote a natural pollination of the plants. Every kid's tea time dream. Just look at the mouth-watering succulence of the fruit they produce here. Half of all they produce is sold in the local shops, or bought by the public in the old-fashioned way, pick your own.
It's fine.
The other half is brought here to their factory to be processed into a whole variety of different strawberry products, all of which are on sale at their shop in Pornic, which is new since I first came here in the 1980s. Here you can find ice cream and sorbet, perfect for a summer's day by the sea, and any number of other goodies, like the liqueur that I'm going to use for my very special strawberry tart. Other fruits may get a look in, but strawberries are a way of life, so you won't be shocked to find out what Francois' favourite flavour is.
I like every flowering, but my favourite is, of course, strawberry.
Now there's a surprise. Strawberries, don't you just love them?
Beautiful.
Fantastic. So I thought I'd do like a lovely sort of French strawberry tart to go with this, using some of the liqueur and puff pastry. In the UK, for some reason, we never have butter puff pastry. Now we're starting to get the hang of it, but puff pastry is so much better if we use all butter.
Yeah.
We kind of use margarine and the cheaper fats. But you can see the butter. Look at that lovely yellow colour.
Silky, isn't it?
Now, what we're going to do is cut this out. Now, you can leave this as it is if you wanted to, but my oven's not big enough. It's about that big. So that's the size of the tart. All right, so what we're going to do is then just chop this up and then carefully lift this off onto our little non-stick mat. There we go. If I can get you to get rid of that.
Yeah, lovely.
Cheers, mate. Now, the best way of actually doing a little tartlet is use a table knife. Take your knife and just basically make a frame around the edge, but you're cutting halfway up the side of the pastry. So roughly that's what you want. Now, always top tip that I learned over here was always dot puff pastry with a knife, never with a fork. The reason why puff pastry rises in the first place, that it's layers of butter and pastry together. And as the butter melts, it creates steam and causes the puff pastry to rise. But this stuff, because it's quite thin, we want a wafer thin French fruit tart. So we need to make sure that the pastry doesn't rise too much. Keep it nice and flat, but you get that lovely flavour. Can you do me an egg yolk? Mate?
Yeah, sure.
There you go.
So by not doing that border, then that's going to rise higher. Is that
right? Yeah, that little bit, tiny bit, but because the pastry is nice and thin, I want to keep it nice and thin because I want the emphasis on the creme pat and the strawberries, really, and just basically the puff pastry is there just to hold it together.
Yeah, yeah.
I think often with sort of tarts and stuff like that, people make them out of puff pastry. It's too much. You just want to use a small amount.
There you go.
There you go. The best pastry brush in the world. Your finger. All right. Around the edge. And then pop that on there. If you can do me 3 egg yolks.
3 egg yolks, yep.
Meanwhile, this will go in the oven. So with all puff pastry really, including this one, it's good to cook it in quite a hot oven. So about 200 degrees centigrade, that's about 400 Fahrenheit, gas 6 or 7. But on this little thing, full, gas 9. Straight in, once about 10 minutes. Now with this, I thought we'd do a creme pat. Very classic French filling, particularly with tarts. If anybody's had Danish pastries and stuff like that, creme pat would always be inside. Now, all you do is we've got some egg yolks here that my main man did, bit of milk. Now, if you can then split me a vanilla pod.
Yeah, sure.
Now, these are proper vanilla pods. If you're back home looking for vanilla, then go for Bourbon vanilla from Madagascar. That's what you're looking for. So much fatter pods, the same as what we've got in here. Intense flavour. Really good. Chuck the vanilla in. What we need to do is just infuse the milk with vanilla. Now, the other ingredients for this, pretty straightforward. You can measure it if you want, really. It's kind of like guesswork, really. But you've got some sugar, just a touch of sugar, and a bit in there. Now, sometimes creme pat can be made with flour. I actually use corn flour because I find it much better, much smoother in texture. So you want a couple of bits of that. Now, if you can pour on the milk.
Right.
There we go. So we've got the egg yolks, the sugar, strain about half of that.
Oh, cool.
Try and get it in the bowl.
Yeah, all right, all right.
Whoa.
All right.
Unbelievable. Put that back on the
right.
Yeah. And then all we do is place this back in the pan. Just mix it. I'll take the vanilla out now. And it wants to come to the boil. Okay, as you can see now, it starts to thicken up. Look at that. Perfect. And the texture is much better, I think, if you make it with corn flour.
Yeah, it looks silky, doesn't it?
Yep. And we're going to take some of this strawberry liqueur. Throw that in as well. We actually use Mirabelle. When I was over here.
Yeah.
It's exactly the same tart as what I'm making now, but these Mirabelles are these lovely, sort of, almost like little green fruit, yellowy sort of green fruit that I used to make this exact same tart with some, I hate to say it, 18 years ago. 18 years ago. Oh, there you go.
Oh, look at that.
Just cool down. Nice and simple. You can prep me some strawberries, please.
Yeah, sure.
Martin, thanks. Just take the tops off, that's fine for this one. Now, really, what I thought we'd do with this is just to, you know, change it slightly. I thought we'd just make a syrup using some of this sort of strawberry liqueur, a bit of sugar as well, just a nice syrup, and then I thought we'd warm the strawberries through it, make it quite nice. Now, all we do with this is get a nice hot pan, really hot, take some of this lovely strawberry liqueur. Just a small amount. Flaming off the alcohol there. In we go with some sugar. That is quite hot coming off that. In we go with the strawberries. Now at this stage you could put a little bit of black pepper in there, anything like that, but you can see this lovely glaze that you get with the sugar. It's almost that instant glaze. And one thing that I hate about tarts like this really, it's covered in conventionally in that horrible sort of thick apricot glaze.
Yeah, and it takes away, it's got no value, it doesn't taste
anything. It
takes
all the flavour away from stuff like that. Yeah. If you've just got the fresh, look at that, fresh strawberries in there, you don't really need anything else, just the sugar. You've made your own glaze there. You look as if you know what you're doing, if anything else. Just, that's enough. Just
that enough? Just
spread that.
Oh yes, this is looking good. How's that?
Oh, I tell you. And then what we do now, if I bring this across, look. Slightly too much custard on there, you know what I mean?
Well, I don't know, I think if you like custard, you know.
There's slightly too much custard on there.
You've got that Northern expression.
You're
like,
if you're doing this at home, slightly less custard, you know.
Give them plenty, but cut it down.
Just put slightly less on it next time. Not bad, that.
That's all right, though, mate.
Fantastic.
What can you say? Nothing. Yep. Beautiful.
Well, thanks for coming anyway.
Nah, thanks, mate. It's been great.
You're a star.
Cheers.
You enjoyed it, didn't you?
I loved it. Yeah. Back to basics. Real.
Yeah.
Love it.